Hey guys, this is Chani and welcome back to my channel. And in this video I'm going to tell you how to create objects in 3ds Max. So before creating any object in Max, it's very important to set its unit. So how do we do it? For that we go to customize, go to unit setup. Now as you can see this dialog box in front of you, you can set any of the unit you desire. So there are four options. You can go to metrics, you can go to feet, inches, you can also customize your own unit, set it up, and there is this basic generic units, and select any you want and click OK. So let's see how to create simple shapes. So you can select different category from here, but as of now we'll go to basic shapes. For that we have to go to standard primitives. So there are many object types here. As you can see, there is this box, tube, cylinder, torus, teapot, sphere, and so on. We'll see how to do it. Simply you have to select the command, you have to go to any view, click, drag, and click again. So this is how we make objects here. Let us try a few more. This is how we do our cone. This is our cylinder. You can also change the color. For that you have to select the object. For suppose here, as you can see, this teapot is already selected. We'll change its color. You have to go here, and from here you can give any color to it. So this is how you basically create these basic shapes. So there is some difference when you create objects in different viewports. We will see how and what is the difference. So let us, for example, select a cylinder. You click, drag, and click again. We'll change the color. So what happens? Let us make one more cylinder in top view and see the difference. So we go to top view. As our cylinder is already selected, so as of now we have to understand what is the difference between if we make the same in different directions or viewports. So now for that, let us go to front view and try to make a cylinder. So here, okay, so what is happening when we created it in front view, it lies on the ground. That's because there is the default construction plane, that is three orientations in X, Y, and Z direction. So it is getting extruded in some different plane. So with this we understand that there are three default construction planes, that is three orientation of an object, and it entirely depends on which plane you are creating it and which direction you are extruding it. So it helps you when you create your views. There is one more thing about creating our object, is that we can create more grids. Okay, for that let us do one thing. I'll just maximize it. We'll create one box. Okay, so this is my basic grid, basic three-dimensional thing. So this is my basic three-dimensional grid, okay, which is by default, as you can see. Now there is one more thing, that we can also create more grids apart from this default one. So for that, what do we do? There are four viewports. Okay, so you can go to any required viewport. I'll work on perspective. So you have to select an object. My object is already selected here, and you have to go to this auto grid. You have to activate this auto grid. So what happens in viewport, can you see this tripod? This appears. Okay, so it appears and it shows you different orientation across the object. Can you see? So this is how it shows the different orientation across the object, which also indicates the face of orientation of an object. So let's see how does it happen. So as I'm making a cylinder, as you can see here, there is this one more grid which becomes the primary grid for the object I'm making. That is the cylinder. Okay, so this grid becomes the primary grid for this object, making the default grid temporary. This is how it works. So we can, you know, simply, this is how it works. So autogrid is an important command. We can use it in many ways. You will see how once you will start practicing it. Also, there is one more thing. You have to make sure that you turn it off once you are done. Okay, this is how it works. There is one more thing that you can do with the objects is you can give them the name. For that, you have to select the object. You have to go to this modify panel and you have to give here the name. And it is always better, you know, to give the name in a serial wise. As you can see, there are three cylinders here. You can, yeah, I'll select again and here cylinder 01. Okay, then I have selected this and I'm giving here 02 and 03, 04, so on. So this makes your working easy. So what happens, this makes your working easy when you are working with many objects. So it gives you a sync. Okay, also you can change the color of your object from here. You have to go to this color panel, whatever color it is showing in your window, that is okay. You have to select any color, put okay, and this will be basically the wireframe color. This is very important. This is not your solid color, this is your wireframe color. So guys, this is all about creating objects. This is very basic about it and we will see everything in detail. And please practice it and see if you have any doubt on all the videos I have made so far. You can email me or you can actually comment on the section below. I'll reply to it. I hope this video is useful for you. If you like it, please like my video, share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click on the bell icon as it is going to notify you for my further upcoming videos. Have a nice day. Thank you.